Now, what is chemistry? During the beginning of this lesson, I already defined for you chemistry, but that was not a real full definition for chemistry. It was just a brief sneak peek towards what chemistry is all about. Now, when you look at this picture here, you will find that we have different substances. For example, this one here. It's red in color, put in a container that is made of glass. So the substance that is inside the glass is a liquid. That one, the container that holds it, is a solid. Anyway, so why do we study all this chemistry? Because we want to learn about this matter, the states, the changes, the properties, and how they relate to each other. Now, a good definition for chemistry that we can apply is: chemistry is the study of the composition, structure, and properties of matter and the changes that matter undergoes. Now, when we were talking about the states of matter, we said that we have solid state, we have liquid state, and gaseous state. Now, substances can exist in solid state, but at different temperatures, when you heat solids, they reach a point, a temperature, that they will turn into a liquid. Likewise, when you heat a liquid, it may reach a certain temperature that it will turn into a gas. And the reverse is also true. When you cool a gas to a certain temperature, it may come back to form a liquid. And when you cool a liquid down to a certain temperature, it may form a solid. So, that's what we are interested in. These changes, these structures, these properties of matter and how they relate to each other. Now, before we go on to study these, we need to learn about how chemistry is very important to us in the society. So that's where you go to the role of chemistry in the society. Chemistry has very many roles. But in this time, because of time and space, we are going just to learn a few of the roles of chemistry. To begin with, chemistry is very important in the manufacture of drugs. Now, drugs can be used for various purposes, such as treatment of diseases. Now, this treatment of diseases is very important because when you're sick or you're feeling pain, you will go and buy some painkillers. Yeah, so this picture here shows a little bit of a mixture of many drugs. But all in all, chemistry is very important in the manufacture of these drugs. Without chemistry, who knows, we would not be having all these drugs, so that could help us when we get sick. Next, we have it is used in the manufacture of plastics, to make toys, chairs, containers, plastics, roofs. We also have computers, televisions, name them. There are so many uses of plastics. Not like this little nice toy that you can buy for your kid and he'll play with it. Anyway, when you have kids, not right now. Next, another role of chemistry is used in the extraction of metals, minerals such as aluminium. We also have other metals that can be extracted using knowledge in chemistry, such as sodium, copper, nickel. We also have aluminium. Oh, I've already mentioned that. Well, this is an industrial process. That is very important because these metals, as we have seen, can be conductors of electricity and therefore can be used to make electrical cables that are very good and very useful for us in the society. Next, chemistry is very important in oil refinery. Now, oil is obtained from underground in form of what we call crude oil. Now, crude oil is actually a mixture of many petroleum products. And this mixture can be separated using a special method known as fractional distillation. So in this case, chemistry is very important because, as we will learn in the next lessons, fractional distillation is a very important method of separation of mixtures. So because of chemistry, we are able to obtain crude oil from the earth crust and refine it into the various products. Now, who can name some of the products of crude oil? If you know them. Okay, one is petrol. We have kerosene, diesel, and many more. Now, next, chemistry is very important in the manufacture of dry cells and car batteries. Now, this goes without saying that the role of car batteries is to provide electrical power to the vehicle. While it can also be used to manufacture dry cells that are used as a source of power for small gadgets, such as remote controls, we also have toys, we also have clocks, watches, etc. The next role of chemistry is in the manufacture of soaps and detergents. Now, we all like to be clean, and therefore we wash, washing of clothes, we have cleaning of surfaces is done using soaps and detergents that are manufactured using the knowledge of chemistry.